Signal confirmed. Reapers eluded. I found something. Dig up any information on the mission, Liara?
I did, and I now understand why High Command wanted to hide it. We're headed to an Ardat Yakshi monastery.
Ardat Yakshi? Like Morinth?
Morinth chose to be a killer. These Ardat Yakshi isolated themselves to avoid that. But it doesn't mean they're harmless. Their urge to feed can be powerful. That's why High Command sent in commandos to investigate the monastery's distress signal.
So what does the Asari High Command want us to do?
If there was a chance the Ardat Yakshi could break loose, the commandos were to purge the monastery.
Purge? You mean destroy?
They would have brought heavy explosives with them, yes.
Morinth was dangerous, but are the Ardat Yakshi this big of a threat?
Morinth was just hitting her stride. Ardat Yakshi who kill leave behind astronomical body counts. It's why they can never be free, and why they're such a great source of shame to the Asari. That's why High Command won't rest until this place is destroyed. They'd never risk a single Ardat Yakshi getting loose.
Don't assume anything. Maybe the Ardat Yakshi sent out the distress call. If the Asari want us to destroy this place, I need to know what happened.
Agreed. Once we give a report to High Command, they'll stop wasting lives here.
Visor's IR says this shuttle's warm. Recent visitor?
Elevator disabled. To prevent entry or escape, I wonder.
Stay sharp. I heard something.
That was me. Sorry. Reapers. Looks like we know why the commando teams went silent.
This monastery's out of the way. What do the Reapers want with Ardat Yakshi? Anything useful?
A floor plan, marked with the nav point location of a bomb. It's in some place called the Great Hall.
At least it's no surprise nuke gone to Chanka, but the commandos want this place gone pretty badly.
Ardat Yakshi or not? Evacuating this place would have saved a lot of lives. If there's no survivors, let's get to the Great Hall and set off that bomb.
Very good. I almost didn't hear you.
Samara?
It has been some time, Shepard. You are a most welcome sight. The corruption here runs deep.
What brings a Justicar out here?
My daughters have lived here for centuries, Garrus. I've come for them. Unfortunately, the Reapers had already infested this place by the time I arrived.
You met me hunting down your other Ardat Yakshi daughter. Are these ones just as dangerous?
Falair and Rila have followed the monastery's rules ever since they arrived. They've shown no inclination toward violence.
And you're here to save them?
They are my responsibility. And it's one that cannot be abandoned, even as our galaxy crumbles.
Let's go together. Maybe your daughters can tell us why the Reapers hit this place.
I suspect they will have much to tell us. It has been centuries since I last saw them. We're out of time. We'll meet again. I will draw these creatures off.
Wait! Let's go. This fight didn't last long by the look of it.
It wouldn't. The monastery only had a few guards to protect it, not an army.
Used to be a person. An asari. What have the Reapers done?
As soon as I was able. Shepard, this is Falair, my youngest. She and her sister Rila are Ardat Yakshi. They have
Mother!
Been...
They have Rila!
What?
I saw some of those creatures take her into the Great Hall. I've been trying to get there.
What are the Reapers doing here?
Harvesting us. They're turning us into... those... monsters. Please, you can't let that happen to Rila!
The Asari thought the Ardat Yakshi were to blame for the attack.
This is our home. Most of us are grateful to be here. The monastery is a place Ardat Yakshi can achieve peace.
Valer speaks truthfully, Shepard. I vouch for her words with pride.
Then we have to find Rila fast. The Great Hall has a bomb in it.
A bomb? What, didn't you come to rescue people?
We'll try, but we can't leave this place standing, Valer.
You sound like the commandos. They didn't stop to help anyone.
Valer?
I'm sorry.
The Great Hall. She's looking for Rila.
We'll meet you there.
Please be swift.
Need a crowbar to pry those doors open.
This place was beautiful before the Reapers came.
Ardat Commando. Was she holding off Reapers or was she left behind?
Commandos work as teams. She would have volunteered to guard this point.
Hope she took some down before she died.
And Falair.
Rila, wake up!
Falair, Rila cannot hear us.
Look, she's still alive.
I know, but I am afraid Rila is not well.
Rila's not one of them yet. She can't be. She just needs to wake up. Rila? Rila, can you hear me? Why did she do that?
Because they've begun to turn her into one of the Reaper's creatures.
I'm sorry. Can we set off that bomb?
Not without a detonator.
Commandos would have had one. We've got to find it. Later. Let's get back to that bomb.
Falair, go! Take the elevator! Rila, what are you doing? It's too late for me. There are hundreds coming. Just go!
Move!
No! Rila!
I love you.
Rila!
Thank you.
We're not your slaves. Even time to say goodbye.
Few can break the Reaper's hold. Rila's will was extraordinary, as was her love for you.
We left her to die.
Rila made her choice, and it has reminded me of what is truly important. Why I swore I'd lay down my life.
What is that?
Valair, the code demands an Ardat Yakshi cannot live outside a monastery that no longer exists.
What are you doing?
I'm sorry, Shepard. By the Justicar's code, there is only one way to save Valair.
Mother, no!
My daughters, you were all so much stronger. Let go.
What are you doing?
Fulfilling the code.
By throwing your life away?
I won't kill my last daughter.
You won't have to.
Valair?
I'll stay here. Home. No matter what's become of it.
Without a proper monastery,
I could have left any time. I don't need a building to honor my own code. And if the Reapers return, they won't take me alive. I promise.
Then, the code permits you to stay, as you are. Once this war is over, and if I am able, I will visit, as a Justicar should.
I'd understand if you wanted to help Valair rebuild a home here.
It must wait now that I can help oppose the Reapers. I'll speak with Valair, then join your forces. If you'll have me, of course.
I'd be honored.
The honor is mine, my friend.
Everything's taken care of down here. Bring in the shuttle.
Right, Commander. I'll just follow the smoke.
I read your report, Commander. We had no idea the situation had deteriorated so quickly.
That's why I set off the bomb.
May the Ardat Yakshi find rest. What the Reapers did to them was monstrous. I had another team of commandos headed to the monastery who I can now formally transfer to Admiral Hackett's command. They'll serve you loyally, Commander. Farewell.
You'd be more sympathetic to someone joining Cerberus. You've never been big on aliens.
Yeah, I enlisted to kick ass, just like everyone else. and I need a better reason than it has scales to go kill somebody. And if Cerberus is taking our dishonorable discharges and Cat 6 washouts, it's just one more reason they're not worth it.
Unread messages at your private terminal, Commander. The Crucible Project received some new tech from the Asari government.
I'm glad they've decided to help the war effort.
Everybody has to fight now, no matter how pretty you are. I learned that the hard way. Commander?
Glad you talked Samara down.
I never thought I'd see her flinch from her duty.
I don't know. On one hand, that code's all she's had to live by for, God, centuries. And the galaxy goes to hell? The old rules don't cut it anymore? I mean, we're cutting some corners, right?
A few.
Well, the Alliance can always court-martial us after we save the galaxy. Commander?
What are you doing, Edie?
Monitoring reports of proton storms and other space weather. With the Reapers attacking the comm buoy systems, critical warnings may be lost.
How bad are these storms?
If we are warned, not bad. If we are not warned, very bad.
Thanks for the info, Edie.
Hello, Shepard.
Everybody was fighting the Rachni, trying to push them back through the relay. Finally, the Krogan were turned loose and stopped them.
I see.
But when the Krogan rebelled, we had to deploy the Genophage to stop them. Wasn't the only rebellion. 1,000 years later, the Geth revolted against the Quarians. That was a whole other war. Then along came the humans. My own people tangled with them for a while, and now, to top it all off, we've got the Reapers. What about you?
The Ouroboros fought the Densorin. The Andoromai conquered the Vandomar. And the Jatil turned against the Jah.
So, I guess nobody really ever gets their act together.
The Sinriel claim to have found the path to eternal peace.
What happened?
The Dittaka preferred war and wiped them out.
I hope you guys had alcohol.
Some of the crew seem shocked by the monstrosities we have encountered. They haven't seen what the Reapers could corrupt after 100 years. That was our war. Every battle conjured a new nightmare. This human holds such childish views of war. Your species has much to learn. Commander.
Samara's the kind of soldier we need in this war. Nothing gets in her way. I just hope I'm not in her way someday. That woman means business. Now it's a mutated Asari. The Reapers are just a giant nightmare factory that never ends. I can only imagine what the Reapers are doing to the Drell. Or the Hanar. or the Vorcha, this could get a lot worse before it gets better. Good to see you.
Commander.
It's a brilliant tactic, when you think about it.
But it's evil.
When has that ever mattered in war?
Yeah, but converting other life forms into Reapers? I can't wrap my head around that.
Makes sense to me. It ensures you never run out of cannon fodder, eliminates any local resistance, and for every soldier you add, your enemy loses two, the one you converted, and his buddy on the other side who can't pull the trigger on a friend.
You sound like you admire them.
Same way I admire a virus or a thresher maw. They've adapted perfectly to their situation.
But the Reapers want to destroy us.
And I have no intention of letting them. But if you don't respect your enemy's capabilities, you're in for one nasty surprise after another.
Hey, Commander. I dug out some letters my youngest sister wrote when she was in high school. She was having a hard time. Teen drama and all that. Just needed her big sis. I guess with everything that happened down there, I just wanted to read them again. You sure make some unusual friends, Shepard. That is not a side of the Asari I ever want to see. Shepard?
Found useful information in the data you recovered, Commander.
Poor Rila. But I'm glad she set off that bomb, Shepard.
You're not upset the monastery was destroyed?
No. Not after what I saw. I don't care that they were Ardat Yakshi. To be turned into such creatures, nobody deserves that. Hello, Shepard.
The Ardat Yakshi? No.
I think that story would be perfect for you. The hidden dark side of the most beautiful race in the galaxy.
We have a huge Asari audience. If I do that story, I could lose them.
That seems a bit like pandering.
Ever seen how fast an e-democracy can abandon its allies?
No.
If I do my job, you won't. Does Dr. Tassoni ever let you in her room? Because she keeps me out. Do we need to talk, Commander? Not right now, Allers. Let me know when we do.
Oh, come on! The M44 Hammerhead is vastly superior.
Come on, that thing's made of tissue paper. At least the Mako can take a few hits.
I'd hope so. That thing handles like a drunk rhino. No agility whatsoever.
More like a bull that can climb and climb for days.
It only climbs because of its stupid, vertically aligned Mass Effect fields. Jump or stick. No speed. No lateral movement.
Hey, with a cannon like that, who needs to move?
If you want that, why don't you just stick with the old M29 Grizzly?
Hey, I love that tank.
You would be one to love grizzly bears, Mr. Vega.
What? What's so funny?
The next time you blow up a monastery, let me know you left the premises, okay? I worry about you. Good to see you, Commander.
Hey.
Signal confirmed.
Found something.
Signal confirmed. Faster than light jump successful.
found something. Evasion successful. Reapers eluded. Faster than light jump successful. Evasion successful. Reapers eluded. Faster than light jump successful. Evasion successful. Reapers eluded.
You're cleared to dock, Normandy. Do you need ground transport? Yes, Commander.
I hoped you'd come. I won't remain here much longer.
What are you doing on the Citadel, Samara?
I suppose I came to say goodbye. Falaire is safe, and Rila is at rest. I felt the need to speak to you before heading to battle. I want you to know there is no one else I'd rather see leading us in our last hours.
We'll make the galaxy proud. The largest fleet in history is already on our side.
It is impressive. Most would have deemed such an alliance impossible. But, Shepard, be sure to assess your force's strengths and weaknesses before setting out.
Will Falaire be all right in the monastery? Or what's left of it?
We spoke for some time. It won't be easy, but if there is a way to survive, Falaire will find it. It was good to see her again. Perhaps it's unseemly for a Justicar to dwell so much on her family.
I'm just happy things worked out.
I was fortunate that Falaire saw things so clearly. And it would have turned out quite differently without your intervention. Thank you.
You know, I never asked you if your code has anything useful on fighting Reapers.
Treat them as any other enemy. Show no quarter, mercy, or weakness. The only difference is the scale of our foe. The code is too strict to account for such small discrepancies.
Is that how you see it too?
You yourself killed a Reaper on the Citadel, and then another on T'Chunka. I can only follow such bravery.
What are the other Justicars doing for the war?
Most have made it home. They will attempt to hold Thessia. With the odds we face, it's possible our order will no longer exist after this war.
There's that few of you?
Our numbers were never great. We must prepare to sacrifice ourselves, if that is what's required.
Was being a Justicar worth it if that's how it all ends?
The Justicars were formed to bring order to a world that laughs at the notion. The role is solitary. Its demands are lonely and uncompromising, often to the point of pain. But following the code left me with no regrets. Take that for what you will.
Good luck out there, Samara.
You as well. I don't know if you believe in such things, but Goddess go with you, Shepard. We'll both be tested in fire soon enough.
Lieutenant Commander Ashley Williams, the second human Spectre, assisted Commander Shepard in preventing Cerberus forces.
Wait, wait. You asked if I got heavy armor. I never said it was heavy armor. And since when do you know anything about shield capacitors?
I read about them.
Did you say you sold your car a few weeks ago? Because that's around the time I got sent this new armor.
I recovered some texts from a library in Reaper-controlled space. I can have them waiting for you at Bay D-24, if that would help.
Really?
Oh, damn. It couldn't hurt. Thank you. Maybe those texts will help the Asari remember how to fight again.
Hey, Shepard. I'm glad to see you. I know things are crazy right now.
Exactly. So you have to take the moments when you can. So what's going on with you? You still like what you're doing?
Things are good. I'm good.
Still not tempted to come back to the Normandy?
Always tempted, Shepard. But no.
So, you working on the Crucible?
Don't get me wrong. I'm smart. But not that smart. Hackett keeps me busy, though.
How's he doing?
Holding up. If they make old guys any tougher than that, I'd like to see it.
It was interesting to meet Bryn. How is she?
She's great, actually. It's good to see her work without the distraction of having to worry about the colony.
And you and her?
We're having a baby, Shepard.
Wow. Congratulations.
Wasn't exactly planned, but I'm looking forward to it. I'm gonna be a better father than mine was. Do the whole thing right. It's,
One more thing to fight for.
You got that right. Bryn wants to name it after you.
Really?
Yeah. Shepard.
That's nice.
Yeah. I'm gonna talk her out of it. No offense.
None taken.
Good.
What's going on with the Crucible?
That project is crazy. Freaking huge. And all these brilliant minds are working night and day trying to figure it out. I wish you could see them. Heads down, piecing it together. It's something to see. We'll get this Crucible built, Shepard. And then, we'll win this thing. I feel it. Do you feel it?
Yeah, sure. I feel it. And I'm counting on you and everyone there. Get it done.
Believe it.
I'm glad we had time to talk.
Me too. Gotta take the moments when you can. So true. And Shepard, thanks again for getting my people out alive.
Take care, Jacob.
You too, Shepard. I'm thinking about you out there. Stay safe.
Sonorous forces have attacked T'Chanka, apparently trying to beacon the
I overheard what you said. I found this at a Cerberus station. A poison tailored to Turians.
Let me see. Yes, I think this is it. With these schematics, we should be able to come up with an antidote. Thank you. The General might pull through because of this.
I think I know which project you mean, and I've got a Hesperia period statue in Bay D-24.
Commander Shepard, that's excellent news. I'll have it sent to that project right away. Thank you so much for your help.
I got your message, Miranda. Is this about your sister?
Shepard, I need access to Alliance resources. I can't say any more. You'll just have to trust me.
I don't like secrets, Miranda. Just tell me what's going on.
I can't, Shepard. If that's a problem, I'll go.
Don't. Trust is a little hard to come by right now.
Of course.
You'll have your access, Miranda. But I don't like the sound of this.
I know. And thank you. It means a lot.
That's not the only thing you wanted to talk about, is it?
No. I need to tell you something. Confess, really. It's been eating away at me.
Confess?
When I headed the Lazarus Project to rebuild you, I wanted to implant a control chip in you as a safeguard.
I think you mentioned this.
I did. There's more to it. The elusive man stopped me.
Sounds like it would have saved him a lot of trouble.
Maybe. He didn't want to interfere with who you truly were. Something that just obeyed orders. He wanted Commander Shepard. Installing the chip might have ruined you.
I understand why you wanted to. I was a complete unknown.
I've never had to deal with that many black boxes on a project. I felt blind.
Why bring that up now?
I fought against my father and his need to run every aspect of my life. He wanted total control over me, right down to my bloody DNA. After I got out of there, I couldn't stand by and let it happen to my sister. I risked my life to get her away from all that. Yet I didn't give a second thought to destroying your free will when I had the power.
This is what's been bothering you?
Yes.
Miranda, I lost 2 years of my life. You gave me back the rest of it. You could have changed me in 1,000 different ways. But you didn't. I don't know how, but you brought me back.
Thanks. But with so much being uncertain, I just wanted you to know I always regretted wanting that chip.
You can't keep beating yourself up over the past.
I usually don't. But this was important.
Some things you just don't have control over.
Guess my fancy genetics can't help me there.
No, they can't.
Okay. I hate to say it, but I should get moving. Thanks for understanding, Shepard.
Of course. And Miranda, this thing you have to do. Good luck.
Don't worry, Shepard. I always have a plan.
Her name is
Weshra? I have an audio log for you.
For me? Where did this come? Oh no. Oh, Tasha. Thank you for bringing this back. At least I know what happened.
Have you discovered a way to run FTL? Consider this a serious assignment.
I recovered Prothean data drives from Garvug. I'll have them brought here.
Commander Shepard, thank you. I'm sure that'll help with any operation we have going.
Commander Shepard, a pleasure to see you again, though I wish it were under better circumstances.
I'd hope for your support in the fight against the Reapers. What's going on?
17 days ago, with precision strikes on 4 Geth systems, the quarians initiated the war to retake our homeworld.
Which was a clear violation of our agreement with the Council to avoid provoking the Geth.
A treaty violation is nothing compared to recovering our homeworld and advanced AI technology.
Your Your homeworld? You mean Rannoch?
Correct, Commander. 300 years ago, we lost our world to our own AI creations, the Geth.
After we attempted to kill them?
We didn't try to kill them, Chorus. We tried to deactivate them. It wasn't murder.
No, it was murder.
Commander, the Quarians never intended to create a true AI. It was an accident.
Which you chose to correct by trying to kill them.
Don't bother! Admitting we were wrong would undercut the justification for this suicidal invasion plan.
You're throwing yourselves at the Geth? Again?
And this time, we may have destroyed our people for good.
We'd driven the Geth back to the home system when this signal began broadcasting to all Geth ships.
The Reapers.
Under Reaper control, the Geth are significantly more effective. Our fleet is pinned in the home system. If we're going to win, we're...
Win? You insisted on involving the civilian ships, Admiral Geralt. We need to retreat or we'll lose the lifeships.
Where's the signal coming from?
Here. A Geth dreadnought. It can outgun anything we've got, and it's heavily defended.
The Normandy's stealth drive can get us in undetected. I could board, then disable the Reaper command signal.
Yes. Cutting off the signal should throw the Geth into complete disarray.
And while they're confused, you get to amass relay and retreat.
Good. Our civilian ships have seen too much fighting already. Are you certain you can disable the signal?
We'll get you out of there safely, Admiral.
Our newest Admiral has also volunteered to offer technical expertise.
Tali Zora Vast Normandy, reporting for duty.
Glad you could make it, Tali. Admirals, already a team to hit that dreadnought.
Thank you, Commander.
Admiral?
It's mostly a formality. I'm an expert on the Geth.
That you are.
I'm glad you're here.
If I'd known it was this bad, I would have come sooner.
You've had your own troubles. I'm sorry about Earth. We've got the largest fleet in the galaxy. If you can help us, we'll hit the Reapers with everything we've got. Or however much is left from this stupid war.
I thought you'd support the invasion.
No. After talking to Legion, I thought maybe there was a chance for peace.
So why help them?
I'm an admiral. People look to me for guidance. Public disagreement would divide the fleet.
I'll get your people out of here safely, Tali.
Thanks, Shepard. And just so you know, I need to keep things strictly business in front of the admirals. If you'd like to catch up, let's talk somewhere private.
Sure thing.
I'm ready to hit that dreadnought whenever you are. That dreadnought is tearing through our fleet. Let me know when you're ready to hit it.
So how did you end up back with your fleet, Tali?
When the war started, the Admiralty Board asked for my help. I had more recent contact with the Geth than most of my people. They hadn't filled the spot on the board left by my father. I was invited in. It's just a technicality. I'm far too young to be a real admiral.
Don't sell yourself short, Tali. The board needed your expertise. You needed the authority that comes with rank.
How did the war with the Geth get started anyway?
Admiral Zen developed a scanning countermeasure that interferes with Geth active scans. It's like a flashbang grenade. It effectively crippled the Geth ships in combat. My fleet couldn't pass up the chance to attack.
Could we use it to fight the Reapers?
It only works against the Geth, unfortunately. Their AI lets them use extremely detailed radar pings. Zen's countermeasure overwhelmed them with garbage data. And it's useless now that the Reapers have upgraded their processing power.
How is it being back with the fleet?
Right now, it's exhausting. I'm an admiral in the middle of a war. I just want us to get out of this alive. Everything else can wait.
When this is over, I could use your help.
I can't, Shepard. If we survive this, we'll have a homeworld. My people need me.
You could help your people's homeworld by fighting the Reapers.
I don't know. Like I said, I'm not thinking that far ahead yet.
So what about Legion?
It returned to Geth space after you turned yourself into the Alliance.
And you haven't seen it since?
Legion and I sent a few messages. I was hoping we could try negotiation. But I was outvoted 3-2. Admiral Corus was the only one who believed it would work.
Any idea where Legion is now?
No. In our last message, it told me that the Geth were having trouble reaching consensus.
And then nothing?
Maybe it was fighting the Reaper takeover, or maybe it didn't want to give intel to an enemy. I could have warned it about the invasion. I didn't.
You'd have been betraying your own people.
I never wanted to be an admiral.
Talk to you later, Tally.
If you want to catch up in private, call me up to your cabin.
Shepard, the fleet is under heavy fire. We need to hit the Dreadnought.
I'd like to know about your patrol fleet.
In peacetime, the patrol fleet managed navigation, internal security, and intership conflicts or crimes. Now, we mostly guard a heavy fleet's flank. It's mostly light frigates or fighters.
Tell me about the civilian fleet.
Our civilian ships, medical vessels, and life ships. Admiral Corus coordinates them, though individual ship's captains still have power. In peacetime, they made up the bulk of our fleet. Now, our strength would even give the Turians pause.
Tally said you had the largest fleet in the galaxy.
The Turians have more dreadnoughts. Their overall military force is larger than our heavy fleet by far. But before we began this war, we jury-rigged every quarian ship in the flotilla for battle. Even our live ships have cannons.
You've converted them into dreadnoughts. That's a violation of the Treaty of Ferrixen.
Why live ships have firepower comparable to a dreadnought? Their primary purpose is food cultivation.
You think the Council will buy that technicality?
If need be, I'll apologize once this war is over.
And in the meantime, you're putting your civilians in danger.
Not casually, Commander. We keep them off the front lines, but we'll do whatever we must to win.
What can you tell me about Admiral Garrel's heavy fleet?
It was our main military force before the war, comprised of all quarian vessels suited for sustained combat. It can't compare to the Turian forces, of course, but we have a number of heavy frigates and advanced fighter forces.
Tally said you had the largest fleet in the galaxy.
The Turians have more dreadnoughts. Their overall military force is larger than our heavy fleet by far. But before we began this war, we jury-rigged every quarian ship in the flotilla for battle. Even our live ships have cannons.
You've converted them into dreadnoughts. That's a violation of the Treaty of Ferrixen.
Why live ships have firepower comparable to a dreadnought? Their primary purpose is food cultivation.
You think the Council will buy that technicality?
If need be, I'll apologize once this war is over.
And in the meantime, you're putting your civilians in danger.
Not casually, Commander. We keep them off the front lines, but we'll do whatever we must to win.
Which fleet does Admiral Zen command?
Special projects. It's not a fleet per se, just a few research vessels. Her technical breakthroughs have put us within striking distance of the homeworld.
I'll let you get back to work.
Thank you, Commander.
Thank you.
Faster than light jump successful. Evasion successful.